Thank you, sir. I like to be on floor because it is too much distance from the podium, and I want you to get involved and get 100% out of it. International faculty and so much of national faculty, they are devoting their time. Let us talk on Lisfranc. Already much has been talked about the midfoot, so almost all the principles have been covered. We are going to talk about Lisfrancs. Why do we miss them? How to evaluate them, and what are the treatment rationally? Now, if you look at the man, he has not described this injury. He was responsible for the fastest amputation in a soldier through this particular level. So it is called as Lisfranc, but he did not describe the injury. Now, the spectrum of injury is vast. It is from such subtle injury to such frank dislocation. So all these injuries are called as Lisfranc injuries. And look at this. This is, although rare, but commonly missed. It is 2% in occurrence, but commonly missed by us. Now, if we miss, the disability is too much. Let us see why we miss them and how to go about it. Why we miss this Lisfranc injury? Now, this was the injury which was missed initially with normal X-ray. This was the X-ray. Do we read the X-ray, sir? It looks absolutely normal. And after 3 months, look at this. If we see, he turned back to us after 3 months with this collapsed middle arch. We have clearly missed the midfoot injury, the Lisfranc injury, and that's why he is there with the missed the flat foot. Why this injury was missed? It was because the X-ray was non-weight bearing, injury was not anticipated, and complications even were not anticipated. Now, if we miss the injury, what is the problem? It will cause midfoot arthritis, flattening of arch, and whatever we do afterwards will be only salvage and not the reconstruction. We should keep this in mind. So we should be worried about the consequences. They are usually high energy injuries, and when you suspect them, we should suspect if you see this. If you see this on plantar aspect, I think it should make you aware that, look, I may have to investigate for tarsometatarsal injury if it is not really obvious. Should keep compartment syndrome in mind. But the problem is, in neuropathic feet, you will not get the classical pain or classical signs in neuropathic feet. How to evaluate on X-ray? X-ray should be weight-bearing X-ray. That is must. That should be the take-home message. If patient allows, if that is not that painful, it should be weight-bearing X-ray, and X-ray tube should be parallel to the foot and not to the ground. These are few lines you should keep it in mind, like Shenton's line in ankle. You should keep it in mind that lateral border of first metatarsal should be in continuation with the lateral border of medial cuneiform. Medial border of second metatarsal should be in continuation with medial border of middle cuneiform, and similarly these two lines, third and fourth metatarsal. These lines, if you trace and if you find the discontinuity, I think you should be suspicious about the Lisfranc injury. Look at these signs. This is gross misalignment in those lines, or it may be very subtle flex sign. This is a subtle flex sign here, or there is a gross lateral step of here. These do indicate tarsometatarsal joint injuries. Once you identify Lisfranc injury, let us identify all the components. As Dr. Alistair had already told you, look at radius ulna. If radius is injured, do not forget to look at ulna. Similarly, if one component is disrupted, do not forget to look at the other component. If this is the case which will distract our mind to only first and second, do not hesitate to look at 3, 4, 5, even they are dislocated. So identify all the components. MRI may help, but many times you need to read it carefully. Treatment, anatomic reduction is must. Start reduction from medial and go to lateral. Step of more than 2 millimeter, not acceptable. Conservative treatment, you have to be very courageous. I mean, you should have very low threshold to treat Lisfranc's operatively.
On the contrary, if you have to conserve, you have to prove yourself why you are conserving. Can we treat them with K wires? We do treat them with K wires. I have treated this case with K wires. Look at this. All dislocated, I have fixed nicely with the K wires and it looks satisfactory, but look at the end result. First and second landed up in arthritis. Only 4 and 5, they are good. So, no fixation of first, second, third with K wires because they need to be removed in 6 weeks, while these injuries to heal require at least 3 months. So, no K wires please for Lisfranc injuries. Only 4 and 5 can be fixed, but not first, second and third. This is again second important take home message. Now, this is a young girl. How many of you will treat her operatively? Something wrong here. She fell down while walking. And is it worth to offer her surgery? 22-year-old girl. How many of you will think of offering her surgery if you look at this injury? Subtle sign, flex sign. Can you raise hands? Okay, let us see. Only 2 or 3 people they are going to operate. Let us see, this will change our scenario. When we opened it, this was the gap between second metatarsal and medial cuneiform. This gap is enough for us to drive a car through it. So it is that wide. Look at this. This is huge. And if you compress it, it is that small. And look at the video. You should look at it. See this. Even with simple movements, there is gross instability there. So second metatarsal, I am moving very easily. And look at this. See this. Are you able to see it? Such a wide space. This is not good at all. So you should have very low threshold to treat these injuries aggressively. Do treat them operatively. Do not look at the subtle signs. This lady was treated in this manner by passing screws. And this was the result. You can even treat it with small plates. For this particular injuries, we can put plates. Beautiful low profile plates are available. One paper by Coetzee et al, they talk about fusion even for ligament injuries because they do not heal well. So even primary fusion is been advocated, not practiced by many. So take home message, missed cases result in significant morbidity. High index of suspicion is necessary for diagnosis. Anatomic reduction and stable fixation is required. Start reduction from medial to lateral side. Thank you.